Hi everyone, Coinbase goes public on Wednesday, big US banks release earnings this week, the US inflation data, Chinese growth figures, we have a lot to watch, so here are some major events that you should keep an eye on for the week ahead. So as I said, there is a lot to watch on the economic calendar this week, but the two biggest events of this week are certainly the Coinbase IPO through a direct listing on Wednesday and Grab unveiling its going public through a SPAC. And investors can't be more excited, especially for the Coinbase IPO. The Coinbase shares will make their debut in Nasdaq on April 14. So Coinbase is the leading crypto exchange in the US, and as you can imagine, the past year's frenzy in cryptocurrencies sent these companies' earnings to the moon. There are more than 56 million users on this platform, 7,000 institutions, and 115,000 partners over more than 100 countries over the globe, which have generated a revenue of $1.14 billion in 2020, a net income of $322 million, and an EBITDA growth of 2,000% to 500 and something million. So that's really promising. The company is valued up to $100 billion. That's more than the twice of Credit Suisse and Deutsche Bank's combined market capitalization and a touch below Goldman Sachs, which is near $110 billion. So we are talking about a huge company, a huge promise, and a huge interest. Moreover, it's the first crypto exchange listed on a traditional stock exchange, so many can't wait to buy the stock. So I expect to see some impressive volatility as Coinbase shares start trading public on Wednesday. There are gains to be made, sure, but investors should also watch out for a solid volatility as well. Coinbase IPO will be an important test. It will show what's the appetite in a crypto exchange from traditional investors, and I would be very much surprised to see limited interest, to be perfectly honest. But even most skeptics will have an eye on the Coinbase IPO this week, but the market will still say the last word, and we could still have surprises on this front. Bitcoin is pulling out the $60,000 resistance ahead of this much expected Coinbase IPO, as the letter will consolidate the idea of inclusion of cryptocurrencies in the traditional financial avenues. Therefore, we could see Bitcoin also refreshing record this week, especially if we see the solid interest in freshly out of oven Coinbase shares from Wednesday. Second, Grab, so the Southeast Asia's Uber, is expected to unveil its going public through a SPAC, so these special purpose acquisition companies, so the publicly traded shelf companies that merge with a company like Grab to take them public in a different way than your traditional IPO or a direct listing. Now, Grab is valued somewhere near $35 billion, making it one of the leading IPOs of this year in Asia. On a side note, we now hear that the SPAC frenzy could be over with a significant fall in new SPACs, but in my opinion, we will not stop seeing new SPAC deals with interesting names moving forward. It's risky, but it's worth a try for many companies. Now, Asian markets kicked off the week on a bearish note, except from Alibaba shares that rallied 8% despite news that Alibaba will pay a record antitrust fine of $2.8 billion for having abused its market dominance in China over merchants and its competitors. Now, the curious positive reaction was partly due to a relief that the case is finally resolved, partly due to Alibaba taking the news with ease and thanking the government as a sign that the company and the government remain good friends and there is nothing to worry about the future of the company in China. The fine is also no more than Alibaba's 4% domestic sales over a year, while it could have been up to 10%. So that's another relief. Elsewhere, the US index futures ease from record highs, hinting at a lackluster start to the week. At the time I'm recording this show, it's unsure why the investors investor sentiment is that dull this Monday, but the rising inflation expectations ahead of Tuesday's US inflation data and the beginning of earnings season could actually explain a part of that skepticism. The US stock prices flirt with historical high levels, and earnings should absolutely live up to expectations if companies wish to keep investors on board despite prospects of rising taxes, higher input costs, and tighter financial conditions as we move forward. So due tomorrow, this US inflation figure could shoot up to 2.5% year on year from 1.7% printed a month earlier. So far, the tame inflation figures gave Jerome Powell the benefit of the doubt with his prediction that there should not be a major worry regarding a fast rising inflation in the US, that any overshoot in consumer prices should actually remain short-lived, but a jump in the actual inflation data this week could actually spur panic again in the market and weigh on the global risk appetite, weigh on the global risk sentiment. Therefore, the risks in global equities are tilted to the downside at the start of this trading week. Now, the Jerome Powell will speak again today and again later this week, and he will reiterate before and after the US inflation data release his dovish stance until millions of jobless Americans find jobs. So he's done somewhat of a good job training the investor mind that high inflation won't last long enough to compromise the Federal Reserve's inflation target of an average of 2%. So there is no need to worry about the premature tightening of the US monetary policy, he says, and he says, and he says again. Now, investors are somewhat hypnotized right now, but a solid inflation figure could also easily pull them out of that deep hypnotic state and get them to take some profit on some of their risky holdings. So if that happens, we will see the US tech stocks on the chopping block this week. So that's somewhere you need to be careful at. Looking at the risk haven assets, gold failed to clear offers near the 50-day moving average somewhere near $1,760 per ounce, and the positive pressure on the US yields weigh on the yellow metal ahead of Tuesday's inflation data in the US. Solid inflation read could boost demand in gold if and only if the positive pressure on the US yields remain contained. And besides the inflation data, the US retail sales report is expected to print a solid figure on Thursday. Then investors will also watch the UK GDP figure on Tuesday, expected to have retreated 2.9% last month, minus 7.3% year on year. We should see slight improvement in British industrial production in February. Now, German ZUI survey, which should show improvement in expectations, is also due this week, and we could even see some rise in German inflation to 1.7% from 1.3% in March. But rising inflation is not an issue for the Eurozone for now. It will hardly spur the ECB hawks anytime soon. The overall European inflation is still expected to have remained unchanged somewhere near 1.3%, and that will certainly be confirmed by the data on Friday. Christine Lagarde is also due to speak this week, by the way, and she should sound very much supportive given the latest lockdown measures and slowly progressing vaccinations that delayed economic recovery in the Eurozone right now. Now, I believe that the divergence between the dovish ECB and the hawkish Fed expectations, despite Powell's efforts to contain the Fed hawks, should continue weighing on the euro dollar and keep the pair on a bearish trajectory, aiming at a deeper sell-off toward the 117 support that has been tested earlier this month. Now, elsewhere, Chinese trade balance on Wednesday and GDP data on Friday will also be closely watched by investors. Now, according to a consensus of market expectations, the Chinese GDP may have grown 18.9% in the first quarter versus 6.5% printed a month earlier. Such a huge jump in Chinese growth can only revive hopes of seeing an imminent rebound in the world economy, despite the actual lockdown measures we see in Europe and the rising new COVID cases elsewhere in the world. So there is hope and perhaps a reason to support the oil bulls in their battle against the $60 per barrel resistance this week, but price rallies in oil will likely be interesting top selling opportunities for medium-term traders, as we see a clear exhaustion in the oil rally nowadays despite the rising risk assets elsewhere, so you need to be careful if there are any price rallies for the medium term. On the central bank front, the Reserve Bank of New Zealand will likely keep its interest rates unchanged this week, while the Turkish Central Bank, which has freshly fired its new president and replaced him with a newest one, is expected to maintain its interest rates unchanged at Mr. Kavcıoğlu's first monetary policy meeting this week. He knows if he moves lower by an inch, the Turkish lira will get severely punished, you know. So I still believe that with or without a rate change anyway, the Turkish lira will remain under the pressure of higher US yields and a globally stronger US dollar. This is all for today. I'm Ipek Ozkardeskaya and thank you for joining me. I hope this episode of Market Talk has been helpful and insightful to you. Please do not hesitate to follow us on Twitter and on LinkedIn for regular market updates and subscribe to our YouTube channel for daily market comments. I meet you again tomorrow, and until then, good day trading.